In this video, I want to show you how to convert decimal degree coordinates to UTM coordinates in Excel sheets. So if you have your coordinate in decimal degree and you want to convert it to UTM coordinates, I'll show you how to do it in Excel sheets. So for instance, I have these coordinates in decimal degree. If I want to convert it to UTM coordinates, how do I do it? You have your latitude and longitude, and you want to convert it to northern and eastern. So to do that, I have another Excel sheet here. This is it. And I got it from this very arc geek. So I acknowledge, I give credit to the owner. I'm not the designer, I'm not the owner. So I give credit to the owner. So I got it from there, and it's very useful and easy to use. To use it to convert coordinates from decimal degree to UTM or from UTM to decimal degree. So to do that, there are simple settings you need to do. The first thing is that you come here and enter your data. Our number one data is to determine the hemisphere your data belongs to. So the default is south. The hemisphere is south. So click here and change it to where your hemisphere belongs to. Like in this example I want to show you, my data belongs to northern hemisphere, so I will choose north here. So after choosing north, you can see the decimal degree and you see the corresponding conversion to UTM. So let's go back to the data set I have. Now I will copy, let's say I copy this little up to 16 and I right click and copy. So when I go back to that conversion sheet, you can see it. But one thing you need to note is that make sure that the first one you can see is latitude, longitude. So the one you are copying also, make sure it's in that order, latitude, longitude. So after I've copied it just like this, I'll go to the conversion sheet and I'll right click and paste. So once I paste it, it automatically converts it here to UTM. It automatically converts it. But what if in a situation where you have a lot, if you notice, this is where it ends. This is where this sheet ends. But what if you have a lot of coordinates that you want to convert? So to do that is simple as well. So let's go back to the data sets I have here. So let me copy the whole thing. I have up to over 400 coordinates here. Over 400. So right click and copy your coordinates in decimal degree. Then go back to that conversion sheet and right click and paste it. So once you paste it, it will be converted. But if you notice here, you realize that other ones that is more than this conversion sheet are not converted. So how do you go about that? To go about that is simple. What most people do is that some people, if you select it like this and double click, this is not the correct way. This is not, you can see that it's showing not correct. So let's undo. That's not the correct way to do it. Reason being that you can see, if you look at this here alphabet, you see E, F, G is missing. It means some columns are hiding. And as a result of that, if you just did it, what I just did now, by double clicking here, it won't be correct. So the best way to do it is that double click here, bring your console here, double click, continue double clicking until all the hidden column begin to show. So continue to double click until all the hidden column shows up. Just continue double clicking. Continue clicking. Yes, E, F, G, H. So all the hidden column has been unhidden, has been revealed. So also move to this side if you come here, if you look here, you realize that there is an issue here. So there is some column hidden before this AM. We have AF instead of AG, we have AM, which means some column are hidden here. So similarly, we have to double click here to unveil those hidden column. So continue double clicking. Yes, we have now unveiled everything here. So we have unveiled it. Let me reduce the size a bit. So we have revealed all the hidden column. So now let's now go back to where we were. So this one, now you can just select to calculate for the rest. Just select from here like this to the other end like this. Once you've selected it to this end, just double click so it will calculate for the rest. Then let's move to this side. Let's move to this. You can see that it has calculated for everything. So let's move to the UTM conversion. This is it. So we can now copy this. Let's copy it to the end. Yes. So right click and copy. Then let's go to our raw data sheet. This is it. Then let's paste it. Right click and paste value. Yes. So you can call this one now Nodding and Easting. Yes, you can see we have converted it successfully from decimal degree to UTM, or from lat long to Nodding and Easting. So this is how to convert decimal degree to UTM in this Excel sheet. So this Excel sheet, I'll give the link to download it in the description box in case you need it. So once again, I acknowledge the owner. I give credit to the owner. I got it from them. So you can also download, you can visit their site and check what they have. Thank you for watching.